Frozen 2's Dark Sea sequence presented a variety of challenges for the effects team, from large-scale fluid simulations for the ocean to particle mist and rigid body simulations for Elsa's colossal ice structures. Because this sequence required Elsa to run on a fully simulated water surface, the underlying base simulations were completed prior to layout. Elsa needed a clear path to run between 25-foot breaking waves, thus we needed a way to create wave trains with a specific height and frequency that could be reproduced consistently. To achieve this, we created a wave tank in Houdini Flip, using the equation for third-order Stokes waves on deep water to drive the simulations with controls for amplitude and wavelength. Seabed contouring allowed for art-directed control over timing and location of breaking barrel waves. The ice structure that Elsa creates was fractured to allow us to choreograph it buckling from the massive wave underneath. A mixture of rigid body and large flip tank simulations provided us the final result. The fire spirit ignites large swaths of the enchanted forest with magical fire, from the ground up to the trees. To achieve this, we created a library of pyro simulations of varying sizes, shapes, and intensities for effects artists' set dress shots, complemented with custom simulations for fire and magic interaction. The enchanted forest is shrouded by a wall of impenetrable mist, not just a static barrier, the wall needed to actively react to our characters. The basis for the wall was a 1 kilometer wide cloth simulation draped across the scenery. The curtain surface was populated with thousands of small fluid simulations to provide upward motion and the appearance of fluid turbulence. In the climactic finale, the destruction of the dam unleashes an immense flood of water that makes its way through a fjord and threatens to destroy Arendelle. The section where Elsa and the Nock run down the face of the flood required the water to take a specific shape to give our characters a clear read. For this section, we developed a more art-directed approach, where fluid particle sources were sculpted in order to generate a more predictable result.